Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for January the 30th of 2020, well, it is titled Two Clusters and a Comet. So what do we see here? Well, in this case, we see the two clusters known as H and Chi Persei. And those are centered in the center of the image here. And those are two young open clusters of stars. And in fact, what is known as a double cluster, two clusters very close together. Open clusters are relatively young because they are not gravitationally bound together. And that means that the stars within them will slowly spread out over time and disperse out into space and not be together. So we will not see them as clusters over many billions of years. However, they're relatively young, so when they're only tens or hundreds of millions of years old, we can still see them together, dominated by the hot, bright stars that are the brightest ones that we see here. Now, also in this image, we do see a comet, and in fact, three images of the comet known as PanSTARRs, and you can see that up there with the greenish glow up above the double cluster. And this was taken over the course of three different nights on January the 24th, the 26th, and the 28th. So you can see the comet will slowly move relative to the stars. So star patterns will stay the same from day to day and from year to year. The patterns of the constellations that we see today are the same ones that we saw last year and 10 years ago. Stars do not move very quickly, so they will not change their positioning very fast at all. However, comets are objects within our solar system. So their position does change as they continue in their orbit. And that's what we can see over the course of a couple of days each time here, that the comet moved slightly relative to this star cluster. So the comets will move. They do not shoot across the sky like a shooting star or anything like that, but they do slowly move over the course of a couple of days. So you can actually watch the comet and watch its motion. They move much like the planets do, as any other object orbiting around the sun will slowly change its position as we see it here from the Earth. So the comets will slowly change their position, not very quick, and you can notice that easily over just a couple of days. So here we have three different images of that comet that we see. Now we also notice the greenish color of the comet, which is caused by the molecules in the coma around it. And the comet contains a lot of ice, but does contain some carbon compounds. When those carbon compounds are vaporized and released when it comes close to the sun, then they will glow, and the distinct color associated with carbon would be a green color. So it is radiation from the sun, ultraviolet light, that excites these carbon atoms around the comet and gives it this distinct green glow that makes it stand out from the rest of the objects that we see in our image today. So that was our picture of the day for January the 30th of 2020. It was titled Two Clusters and a Comet. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Goldilocks and the Three Stars. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.